In this illustration, we'll analyze a body breaking in oblique collision. Here we are given that a ball of mass m moving with a velocity v along x-axis strikes another ball of mass 2m, which is kept at rest. The first ball comes to rest after collision and other breaks into two equal pieces. One of the pieces starts moving along y-axis with the speed v1, so we are required to find the velocity of the other piece. Here, we can draw the situation to understand it better. So, if this is the mass 2m which is at rest, and we can consider this is the direction we take as x-axis, and this is the direction we take as y-axis. And this body of mass m is moving along x-axis with a velocity v. When it strikes after collision, a particle of mass m of this body moves in y direction with the velocity v1. And we are required to find the velocity of other part, which will also be of mass m, because it is given that it breaks into two equal pieces. So, to conserve momentum, we can consider this would be going in this direction with the velocity v2 at an angle theta. So, here as first ball comes to rest and other two pieces are moving in this direction, we can write as no external force is present . A linear momentum of system remain conserved. This implies here we can write along x direction, the initial momentum was mv for the ball which is approaching to mass 2m, and after collision it will be only due to the horizontal component of the particle or the part of this body of mass m moving at v2. So, it can be written as mv2 cos theta. So, this is our first equation. And in y direction, initially there was not any momentum in the system, so after collision total momentum must be zero. So, in y direction it is mv1 must be equals to mv2 sin theta, which is our equation 2. Here m gets cancelled out from these equations, and we can write squaring and adding 1 and 2, here you can see what we'll get. This gives us v square plus v1 square is equals to v2 square, which gives us the velocity of the part which is going in other direction, which is root of v square plus v1 square. And if we wish to calculate the value of theta, we can divide the two equations like 2 by 1 implies the value of tan theta is equals to v1 by v. This implies value of the angle at which the remaining part is going will be tan inverse of v1 by v. So, these are the final results of this problem.